Hello everyone, today let us see about the troubleshooting. For any monitoring tool, it is important to capture various issues in the environment at the right time and in the right way. The second part of that is to be able to troubleshoot. Rather than jumping onto a different service to troubleshoot a problem, the monitoring tool should provide us variety of solutions to troubleshoot those issues from the console itself. So let us get going. So in the monitoring tab, we go to the problems. We can see all the problems in the environment. Here, for example, if at all we see a particular problem that can be resolved to understand what can be done, is I'm just going to left click on a particular host that is having a problem, so we can get to know variety of informations like the inventory part, the latest data, problems associated with that particular server. So this particular list all the problems, the latest data lists the latest data for that particular metrics for that particular server. The graphs is going to plot a graph based on the data collected. This totally depends on the polling frequency and the capturing frequency. And the configuration is going to tell us about what is being configured for this particular alert to trigger in this metric. And then in the scripts part, basically in the bottom, we can see this is quite handy, which is going to help us detect the operating system. It's going to, the second being the ping, that's going to detect the ping about the particular device, and then a fourth one being the trace route, is going to tell us about the trace route. The third one, which I created, which is a dummy one, I'm going to demonstrate how this works. So basically, if I click on the latest data, it's going to tell us about the latest data for that particular device. It's going to pull up all the information. So let's go back and see. Same thing, same device, and we're going to click on problems. It's going to list all the problems for that particular host. So I had two issues for that host and it has listed both. We can see here it is retaining the problems page, but it has put up the host name in the host pane. We go back, we can see that particular filter is gone. Let's go back to the same problem. Here we have the graphs. It's gonna tell us various graphs for that particular device. So this is gonna plot all the graphs that are available for the particular host. So if you're interested in a particular alert, we can narrow it down accordingly. So just by clicking on the problem itself, we can know that this is having a service now ticket INC001025. If you go to this one, it's having a ticket 10022. Accordingly, to go back to the host one, here we have the option of ping. Just click on that, it's gonna get the ping status of that particular device. And it has got us the output. Accordingly, let me also tell you about the dummy script that I created. So on clicking that, I have written the test successful will be popping up, and then when I say execute, it's going to execute the function. Because basically I wrote this to showcase how we can write an external script. This is going to help us to start the services manually, if not automatically, because a service going down can have multiple impacts. Either somebody knowingly has put down the service, or for some reason the service has crashed, in this case the bit service. So I can configure two different things. I can write an action to automatically start this particular service if it goes down, or I can write an external script and then allow the service desk person or the monitoring team to start them manually. So that is going to help any monitoring team or the service desk personnel to act on a particular issue. It is not just restricted to starting of the service. You can have any type of script created to be executed on these devices and work accordingly. So if we click on the problems and then we can navigate to the configuration, it's going to tell us what is being configured here. So this will give us a glimpse as to the problem. Probably if we start analyzing for a longer period of time, we will know that this is a very problematic type of alert and it is recurring too frequently. Then probably the configuration will help us to analyze why it is happening, more so in case of a CPU utilization or memory utilization or any such alerts, and not with respect to a service down in particular. So these are the different ways which can help any team to troubleshoot a particular issue. More in the next videos. See you soon.